Hello and welcome back to Touhoumon Another World. This time, we're going to be taking on the Kanto Victory Road. Of course, you're going to find lots and lots of strong wild stuff around here. So just be prepared for a very long and hard road. A long and difficult road. So as we take out this Mei Ling, just to catch up on what we did in between episodes, I went back and grabbed E-Remilia to get my strength, and I deposited Marissa, El Marissa. So, I don't know if we'll be able to do this all in one episode, even two or three. Victory Road is probably the most arduous part of this entire adventure, which I find to be fitting and not a bad thing at all. Okay. And as you can see, there was some rocks right to our left that were blocking our path, and now they're gone, as indicated by the sound cue. Alright, rappels don't do anything while I have Ho-Oh out front. So let's change that, shall we? We did not go back and heal. Chin's really fast. Oh, I forgot. I want to go and fight every trainer on this Let's Play, so Victory Road's going to take even longer than I thought, because the trainers here are excessively powerful and excessively hard to take down without having to go back and heal. And because of that, it just is extremely difficult with the amount of trainers, especially. Shin can take two of these, right? Yeah, okay. Because it's going to get speed boost, and because we obviously don't have agility anymore, we aren't going to be able to outspeed this. Oh, and they have four restores to make this last even longer. So that crit... Oh, okay, two crits. I'm like, that crit didn't kill, meaning that a regular one would do less than half, meaning there's either a 3 at KO or we can get a crit. There we go, there's the second kamikaze. Okay. I want to see how much an earthquake does against Patchy. I mean, I didn't pick Chin for Chin's power. I picked Chin because I decided that at the start of the game that I would use Chin, and then, well, that was a crit, so hard to tell. But and then I decided to keep Chin along. You know what? Let's just keep Chin out. But, yeah, so I don't know if how good Chin's actually going to be in anything. As you can see, that didn't kill, and oh! Are we dead? We might just die. Oh, no, that didn't actually do very much. Jeez, Chin is strong. I suppose we're our last word fighting an extra, but... I don't know. My stat values aren't that much higher, is it? Okay, for Yanmei, we are going to switch out. I definitely should have gone back and healed. I did not realize it did not heal. I guess we'll be taking an early trip back. Are you kidding? No burn, and it didn't kill. We're going to be taking an early trip back, probably after the next battle, to, go heal up. But for now, I'm not going to. Even though we're poisoned, I don't want to. I think we still have one more fight in us after this. If Sukiya goes down here, we might want to just go back anyways. This isn't looking good. If we use a psychic. Oh, extra sensory, that's strong too. That'll do about a third. Yep, that is about a third. So if we hit ourselves one more time, and then... Okay, no, we win. Okay, one more battle, and then we go back. Naomi down. And that's minus one full heal for us as well. So, this is a annoying, not puzzle, it literally is just saying here, you can choose one or the other. So, in order to get both, you have to go through this twice. You have to go over there again. And then do that again after leaving. Okay, so this will be our second battle. I can see you're good. Let me see exactly how good. Alright, Isukiya. Dadgummit. Alright, Earthquake, is that super effective? No, it's not. That's just strong. Very strong. Gonna use Poison Claw to deal a little bit of damage and then just hit him with the Earthquake. Hopefully Poison Claw will do enough that Earthquake kills, but it should since didn't have enough that much HP left. I just wanted something that have 100% accuracy and is not Earthquake so he can preserve PP for Earthquake. There we go. And that's why you don't use Crush Top, because it's just going to miss. Ryzen. Okay, time to bring in Amelia. Amelia was a bit injured, but everything else is injured now, so it doesn't really matter. Amelia's not a much weaker than anything else, so there's no point in not using it to preserve it. Because it's not going to die. At least not right now. It may die in a minute. Like, this Byakuin may kill it? Maybe? We'll see. I think I can live this Byakuin. We might die. Like, I don't normally go for suicide moves, so if I'm... going for a suicide move, then it means I think I'll live it. Show! Well, time to see if we can hit a crushed up. There, Sukiya missed the crushed up, but always hit it, because we're talented. That's what it comes down to. We're just a better player. We hit our cross chops. Oh, Lily Black. Okay, more cross chop time. This one's so low level and not even evolved. Well, okay, it is fully evolved, but Lily Black can't get any actual good evolutions. We're an evolution above it, so even if we missed, shouldn't be threatening to us. You had a chance. I would disagree. But now we have a chance to go back to the Pokemon Center. Sadly, we do have to go all the way back to good old the city. Even if we use an escape rope. All it's going to take us to is out here. So now we have to go all the way back to Vermilion City? I'll check when I get there, but yeah. See you guys when I get back. So for you guys all wondering about what's on the other rock, let me get off my bike. Let me flee from this Kasumi? Man, I don't know how to pronounce words. Alright, we don't have Runaway, but we do have good speed. And it's a rare candy! Woo! Rare candies are somewhat valuable. I don't really use them, but they are valuable. Alright, so we're going to get on a bike for a little bit of extra movement speed. And let's head on over to floor 2. Now, floor 2 is, it's just more of the same, really. All the floors here are. So, you push the rock, it gets rid of the thingy, and then you fight a trainer. You push the rock over the button, gets rid of the rocks, and then you fight more trainers. It's, some people may say it's tedious, but I do like much of this, strategy sort of puzzle stuff. I just wish it was maybe slightly shorter, or that there was like a healing point somewhere in it. I mean, nah, the healing point would kind of, that would totally break the challenge of it. It wouldn't be challenging if you're just like, hey, you can just heal whenever. I mean, the thing is that you can. It's just, that's why I don't like, is that it's not a Pokemon's kind of easy. You can just go back and heal whenever for free. There's no actual, hey, you're stuck here and you have to do this with limited resources. You still have unlimited resources. It's just, they're harder to get to. So I guess that's what makes a lot of people not like this. It's more arduous, less easy, more time-consuming. As you can see, these guys are all trying to go for Focus Punch, which is 150 base power fighting move. Pretty good. Only you have to not get hit, because if you get hit, you lose your focus. Or you just die. That is something that happened as well. This guy has three types of Meilings, and they're all going to get hit by flying type moves and die. Man, I kind of wish I do have, could get El Patchy, but I can't. Unless I want to trade. And trust me, I've tried. I don't even understand how it works. I've tried trading in between two Another World games, two Another World save files, between the same Another World save file, between, two different, versions of the save file. I opened up it up on two different tabs and tried trading between them. It didn't work. But, I mean, I don't think you would expect that to work. But yeah, I even tried trading between World Link and another world. And trust me, I don't know, maybe I have to get to a certain point in World Link. I hate World Link. It's so, like, non-linear at the point that I'm at where it's like, okay, you go to Johto, and then, or Kanto, or wherever it's supposed to be, and then you have, like, the mountain. That's Mount whatever, Bob. And then you, like, climb up it, and then you just get lost for all eternity. And I'm just like, I I'm not sure if I have 7 or 8. I'm not sure if I even found the way into the 8th gym. I think I did find the way into the 8th gym. But now I'm looking for the way into, the Hoenn Elite Four. And there just isn't. There just isn't anywhere to go. The Hoenn Elite Four is just, like, non-existent. I can't find a way to fight them. Ooh, this is gonna hurt. I don't know. Maybe I'm just lost, but I feel that this game is way more linear, way less, like, convoluted. It's not even linearness that I like. I like the fact that they tell you where to go and what to do. And you don't have to just run in circles for 5 hours and then eventually accidentally run into the right path and be like, oh, that was what I was supposed to do forever ago. How was I supposed to know that? I don't know. Look up a guide? But who looks up guides? I don't. Why would I look up a guide? That takes away from the fun of a blind playthrough. Alright, so here you see Boulder. Wait. Oh, okay, no, it's just this one. I had rumors of a child prodigy. I'm not sure if that's me or not, but I guess I'm a child, and I'm also really good at this game, so... Sure? Maybe? Maybe you just suck? What is a level 41 doing here? 42, sorry. Like, if this doesn't kill, I'll be seriously surprised. Yeah, what is a level 42 doing here? Not even getting XP off you. My? I guess? Sure. I'll take it. I'll just ancient bow it to the face, and... please tell me it's... No, it's level 42 as well, okay. This guy's just a pushover. I don't understand what he's doing here. How'd you get here with low 40s? Even in the file that I basically save and reset every single turn till I got perfect RNG and so I never had to grind. Even on that file, I was still in my 60s when going through here. Because I did it, for some reason I decided not to use last words because I didn't know how to get them. So I just went through it with Elsukia. Yes, I used Elsukia in my original file. I thought about choosing Yugi to mix it up in this one, or maybe just not use either of them, but the Onis are too good, and we already had a ground type. Alright. Ancient Power should finish this off, and that was the easiest fight that didn't need to exist. I mean, I guess it's free XP, but I mean, I'll be grinding anyways, assuming I actually need to grind to beat the Elite Four and Champion. The rumors were true. Like, I guess he was talking about me. Max revive, nice. Yeah, normally, I do grind. But, since I'm not, you know, completely underleveled from just resetting every 5 seconds to get perfect RNG, not have to grind. Really, I only ever had to grind on, Reimu, but, like, other than that. I haven't had to grind, and I'm actually much higher level than I normally am. But since I'm not, like, doing reset stuff on... Oops. On the Elite Four. Overheat. Okay, that might be good on Marissa. Okay, I'm not gonna go back down because I don't want to mess up anything that I've done so far. I made so much progress that I kind of want to get to the end, skip all these trainers, and then go back and find them later. Dadgummit, I was hoping I could get past you. Only the chosen one may pass. Oh, you mean me? Or, I'm assuming you mean me, because I'm guessing you're going to have level... okay, you actually have decent levels. And, a bad matchup for me. This is not fun. This may do, like, a third, at most. Okay, no, that did half. Okay. No, Chin actually is just a boss. I understand we have much higher base stats, because... We're Elchin, and also we're, what, 8 levels above it, but still. I'm still surprised by how much damage we're doing. Ikomachi, we do literally nothing to it with anything except Familia. So, Familia, time to kill yourself again. Boom. Spinny, spin, spin, spin. There we go. I like how, Ellie. I don't remember. Oh, wait. Ellie's fighting type. Dadgummit. I couldn't remember, I thought Ellie was normal type for a second, I remembered what Ellie was. Yeah, but, all I was gonna say was, I like how, Amelia, Amelia's has, two of her signature spell cards being Dracula Cradle and Okay, here's a normal type, but whatever, the fire thingy, but she doesn't have, Scarlet Devil, her most well-known thingy. I almost reflexively saved so I could just, like, reset the battle if I hit myself. Because I hate confusion. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm switching out no matter what he sends out. I don't even know what he could send out that I wouldn't want to switch out for, but even if it's something that I just need to switch Zukiya back in for. Oh, that would do it. That would definitely be something I want to send Zukiya back out for. But we won't. Instead we'll 2-KO it with Hell's Tomahawk. Cause it'd still be a 2-turn kill and we wanna kinda save Cross Chop PP. Yes, we're using a lot of Hell's Tomahawk PP doing this. Okay, that's going to do nothing because of the burn. Like, literally, we're going to heal it all back. It's a bit worried about confusion, but thankfully that didn't happen. Burn. Actually, we're going to Aeroblast it, even though flying is much more of an effective type here with all the fighting types. But even despite that, the potential to burn with Hell's Tomahawk makes it a much better move, and thus we want to preserve its PP. Plus, I think Ho-Oh's special attack is slightly higher than its physical attack. Alright. So, we're almost done with Victory Road. There's a lot more trainers that I'll need to go back and battle. I'm going to do a video after this of probably just me going straight through and fighting every trainer that we skipped. And it will be a video of lots of battles. And I'll probably just, like, cut after each battle and go on to the next one. Simply because of how long it is. This guy teaches Double Edge, but we don't really care. You've made it through Victory Road, congratulations. Would you like me to teach you Double Edge? I can teach you a technique anytime. Yeah, okay. Excuse me. There we go. So, there's actually one more challenge on Route 23. Picking the right path. If I'm correct, this one? Yeah, okay, I got it memorized. We're good. And now we made it to the Indigo Plateau. Home of the Elite Four. And Repel's wearing off. For a second thought a cutscene occurred. I was going to get put into like an unskippable battle. Or something, and I would just be like, no, I don't have a team for this. We could put Suiko away now because we don't have any need for Surf. Since Surf was just to get through the sort of gateways to Victory Road. So now that we're navigating Victory Road itself for the trainer battles, we have no need for Surf. And of course, Isuika we will replace eventually. Actually, I think Eremilia might. I'll have to see when I go through the Elite Four what is more. More appetizing for me to bring in of my backups. Since, of course, I have not as much. We want 30 of these, right? Yeah, 30. Oh, that's gotta be a hefty chunk. There we go. Well, that's a lot of money down the drain. But thanks to that, we now should be all set to go through the Elite Four. And technically, you only need... you only need 20 revives. And, 20 revives and 24 full restores, but I take a few extra for in battle. Yeah. That's just so after you finish each battle, you can go and fully heal every one of your party members up to full. And so you don't have to worry about going damaged into any of the other battles. Yeah. Anyways, that about wraps it up for this time. Next time we'll finish up battling all the trainers on the Victory Road, and then hopefully move on to the Elite Four. Until then, see ya.